Bostad knocked off his skates. And now Jason Ward has it. Ward just puts it up high. And the Rangers go for a change. Dominic Moore to the bench. And they're one man able to change. There come the Rangers, a 2-on-1. Jagr and Nylander. Jagr backhand. Nylander score! The Rangers go up 1-0 on the 2-on-1. Jagr feeding Nylander.
Well, if the Sabres ever give up a 2-on-1, you don't want to give it up to these two guys. Niemann and help pressures the puck, and there's a turnover near the blue line. Jagr watches kind of fake play to get around the sliding defenseman, and he gives it to Nylander, who really went up top. Nylander's second goal of the season. Look at Kasparaitis. That's a great play. Niemann and held the man up. Kasparaitis turned the puck up ice. 2-on-1. Nylander's shot went right up, almost knocking the water bottle off the top of the net. 1-0 Rangers. That should
not
be
only
from
go out and take the body hard, to make plays after you take the body, recover the puck, make a play, not just hit people.
Gianta for tripping at 13:35. Rangers third power play, 0-for-2 with 3 shots on the power play. Rangers power play 2 for their last 20 over the last 4 games. And they've run into a bit of a rut. Nylander controlling. Nylander gets it to Straka, back to Nylander, he scores! Michael Nylander, it's a power play goal! And the Rangers have tied it at 1.
That evens up the period, evens up the specialty team goals. A shorthanded one for New Jersey, and now a power play for the Rangers. Nylander's third goal of the season. Here's a look at the Panasonic digital replay. It's a 2-on-1 on Rafalski. Straka drives, Rafalski moves the puck to Nylander, and bang, right through the goaltender. Look at Straka get the puck and go back. That drew Rafalski. Opened up the passing lane. Beautiful, beautiful dish by Straka to hit Nylander.
Now it's Nylander to Jagr. Nylander goes to the front. Jagr waits, directing traffic.
They're not going to chase him.
Wants to make a play. Bounced it, and it went in! Jagr made the play, and just what he wanted to do to deflect it off somebody. Nylander may have batted it in, and the Rangers take a 3-1 lead.
You know, when you're trying to guard your people around the net, when the person behind the net has the pucks for this long and nobody gets them, it's hard to stay with your checks. There's the puck knocked down by Nylander, then chipped in. He knocked it down. Let's look at it again.
Clemenson's mask here,
possibly, for sure. Then off the glove of Nylander. Off the mask, glove and down. Maybe not the mask, but I know he gloved it down, but then he put it in with his own stick. Talking about Nylander in front. Jagr wanted the puck. Now he knows nobody's going to chase me. I'll just wait till somebody gets open. And if you're a checker, it's hard to stay with people. Oh, you're right. Mask, glove, stick. Good shot by Stahl. 1-0 Carolina. Last 30 seconds of the period.
Stahl with his 13th of the season, unassisted in 18:58. Rangers tie it. Michael Nylander around the net. Lifted it up over Gerber. And the game is tied as the Rangers score on the 4-on-4.
It's big for the Rangers. 4-on-4 goal from the draw. And it looked like the Hurricanes actually had control. There, Ward moves it around. It looks like it's a Hurricane puck. There's the turnover. Bang. And Nylander on the second shot able to score. Ray Whitney threw the puck flat. Watch 13 over here. He's going to get the puck and then throw it blind. Another blind pass. But he missed his defenseman. Nylander on the second shot. The first save by Gerber took himself out of the play. And Nylander just shoveled it in the open side.
Ball play the points. Kevin Adams bringing the puck down for Carolina.
Nylander got thrown out of the faceoff circle. So Straka playing the point moved in and won the draw and then moved back to the point. That's 4 faceoffs in 3 games that Straka's taken, and he's won every one of them.
Carolina 17th in the league, penalty kill. 2 saves by Gerber, and then it's put in! It's a power play goal, and the Rangers lead it 2-1.
Gerber looking skyward, trying to figure out how it went in. Nylander beats Ward at the blue line. You're going to see a rebound save right there, and then Ward put it in his own net. Ward, the defenseman, wanted to take the puck from Gerber, and I think Gerber wanted to pull it to his body for a faceoff, and with the collision of the two sticks, the goalie stick and the defenseman's stick, the puck goes in the net. Rangers regain the lead, 2-1.
Buffalo. Nylander. Got it over to Jagr. He's got some room. He shoots, save, rebound, score! Michael Nylander gets the rebound of the Jagr shot, and it's 2-2.
See what Nylander did? He got the puck near his blue line, skated up, and all five Sabres were around him, and he made the play. Good pass there. Beautiful by Malik to Nylander. Now watch this. And as he gains his own, look at all the Sabres around him. Four of them there. And then he gave the puck to Jagr, then he went to the net. Rebound, goal. What a smart play. He slowed it down, got into the zone where he couldn't be checked, had four men around him. And then Jagr will get the assist. As there you see, oh boy, not much of an angle, Sam. Wow! There was
a place it in front, tipped away by Malik, knocked down by DeVries. He's checked there by Nylander and blocked by Malik.
And watching games for Atlanta, DeVries is always up ice, trailing and joining the play.
Nylander controlling, feeds Ward, he shoots, save, rebound, score! Michael Nylander! Off the shot by Jason Ward. Shields leaves another rebound, and the Rangers cash
remember,
in.
Remember, DeVries was up ice. He was right near the net trying to force some offense. See, the puck is going to go right into the air, and he knocks it down right there. So he's in deep. Now the Rangers transition goes to work. Look at Nylander. He's on the puck, and he can be quick if he wants to. He leads the rush. Now watch him go to the net looking for a rebound. And bang, it pucks in, and you can tell that Shields is a goaltender that hasn't played a lot of hockey. Look at this juicy rebound and inefficient defensive play by Atlanta. And the Rangers make two line changes, and the two lines score. Just like that.
That's unbelievable.
Just like that.
So in the first 2 minutes, Newton tried to deny the clearing attempt. Blake has it back. Lundqvist got out to stop it. Gasparitis sends it around the boards. Nylander moves it to Jagr. Back for Nylander. Breaks to the net. Fake shoot, scores! Oh, what a night! Jagr, a four-point game. Nylander, a four-point game. Rangers with five straight goals. It's 5-2.
Well, Jagr's pass was brilliant. Actually, all the passes. Straka to Jagr, the little flip pass right through the middle. Nylander just waited. DiPietro went back and down. And Nylander's patience at the net scores the goal. Brilliant little play. Just brilliant. Islanders tried to open it up a little bit just to get some offense. They were down by two. And with doing so, the Rangers were patient and have taken advantage from defense to offense and now lead 5-2. When the Rangers went ahead 3-2, Sam, the Islanders... Let's wish Dave Andrechuk all the best. It looks like he's retiring at 42 years of age. What a career he had. And won the cup with Tampa Bay.
From this scrum, it is Nylander. Wheeling right back and shooting. He scores! Michael Nylander, and Legacy is protesting. Perhaps about a high stick.
It's in the net. Terry Frazier said goal. The Rangers have tied it up with only 14.6 seconds to go in this period. Lang is talking to Terry Frazier, too. Look at, oh, I see why. Look at that. Look at Nieminen driving. Look at that. Nieminen was like a bulldozer into Lang and Lidstrom. He just drove to the net. And as there was a collision, Nylander shoots the puck, and Legacy saying he couldn't make the save because of what Nieminen did. Nieminen drove to the net. He was being held up. He wanted to get to some space. He just started to go. Look at him go. That's like a lead blocker in football. And as he gets there, the puck goes over the shoulder. Oh, and he was right on top of the crease.
And icing waved off. Conchar there to play it. Roosevelt from Fuca and Tootin at 15:48. What a night for Peter Pruka.
Oh, I apologize. I said Ruchinski. That was Pruka on the pass. My apologies.
Nieminen centers and score. Michael Nylander deflects it in. And the Rangers have a 4-2 lead. On the deflection by Nylander off the Nieminen feed.
Remember we said just throw the puck at the net. You never know what happens. Pody made an interesting play here to start it. A lob pass completion. The Giants could have used that, Sam. And then here's Nieminen just throwing the puck to the net. Both Nylander and Ward had been driving to the net. This is what happens when you throw the puck to the net. Beautiful little redirection. Top corner, Rangers lead by two with 3:12 to go.
Jagr two. Cuts in. His pass deflected, blocked, and cleared out by Eliash. Here's Gomez across. Turns and shoots. Stick save, Lundqvist. With 5 minutes to go in the second, Jagr finds the man. Good pass to Nylander. He fake shoots, scores! Nylander from Jagr. It's 2-0 Rangers.
Nylander came off the bench And when he came off the bench, he got himself into a good spot. The shot by Gomez is chipped away. Jagr had been back-checking, and he read the play. Bullseye! Nylander delayed and waited to put it underneath Brodeur, right underneath the armpit, basically, as Brodeur goes down. Watch the puck slide back underneath the arm. 2-0 Rangers. Watch this pass. Playa Jagr's not getting a lot of goals lately, but he's back-checking, he's taking care of business, and he did it on that play. And then he saw Nylander come off the bench and would set up a bullseye pass.
Jagr. Off the end boards, Knubel gets to it. Gave it away to Rutschinski. Moves it to Nylander. Knubel and Gagne, the penalty-killing forwards for Philadelphia. Straka to Nylander, through to Jagr. Jagr waits to Nylander. He scores! Michael Nylander! It's a power play goal!
Oh my goodness. You talk about puck possession. They just move this puck around to different areas of the ice and finally find an open guy, which is going to be Michael Nylander. But the possession, it goes side, it goes back, it goes up and down. People moving. He finds Nylander late. There's so many things have been created that end up that the four Flyer defenders are trying to find the puck. The puck finds Nylander, and it's a goal. What a great pass and a good finish. And this was all the result of about 20 seconds of tremendous puck possession by the New York.
Varada hounded by Straka. Now it's Patrick Eves. Knocked away, Malik fell down, so did one of the Senators.
Verada.
Kelly centers, tipped away, and here's Jagr with Nylander and Straka, 3-on-2. Jagr cuts in, feeds Straka, back to Nylander, score! What a goal! Brilliant passing and a great finish by Michael Nylander. It's 4-1 Rangers.
You want to start this play? That man right there, right in front of Lundqvist, got down on his knees and watched the stick down. There's the play. That broke up the play and trapped people deep. Watch him read the play. There's the play. That trapped three forwards. Now they go. Watch the beautiful passwork. 1-2, bingo. Gorgeous. Gorgeous goal on the rush by the three forwards. Absolutely gorgeous. But it started with the play by Roosevelt.
John tried a shot, but it was partially deflected. Stevenson and Nedved. Rafji. Wow. Here's Jagr all alone in front. Pass. Score! Michael Nylander. It's a power play goal. And what a pass by Jagr.
How did the puck get there, though? It was along the far boards. And all of a sudden, the puck was in front. Jaromir Jagr is tied. Jari Kurri for number 2 overall, only behind Stan Mikita for European-born players with points. There's Straka. He's at battle. And Straka made the play. Yeah. Oh, gosh, what a play by him, and no chance for the goaltender. The goaltender had to think pass or top corner shot from Jagr. Jagr had the two options. He decided to move the puck across. And Nylander finishes. The Rangers power play strikes. And they have the lead after the penalty killing unit was perfect 3-for-3. Wow.
It's on his feet. And Stahl is back on the ice. Teams are at full strength. 1-0 Carolina. Pass off a stick. And Nylander shoots and scores. That puck deflected to Michael Nylander. He was wide open and he fired it by Martin Gerber to tie it at 1.
It's an even strength goal. The power play just expired. Nylander gets his 16th goal of the season. His line is now even for the game. They were on the ice for the goal against. Now they get 1-4 as Jagr worked the puck into the zone. And here's the break as it was more of a pass in front that ricocheted right out to Nylander. Right in here is the play where the puck ricocheted right to Nylander, but the Rangers went to the net, Sam. When Jagr drew three players to him,
Brindamore, good fake. He faked the pass and almost caught the short side. Jagr to Pody, 20 seconds in the period. Kruka, side of the net. Gerber gave it away. Save. They score. Michael Nylander. It's a power play goal.
I made Commodore pay for the nasty hit from behind, cross-checked into Rutschen. And Nylander gets his second of the game. He found the puck in front. It was sitting there, and he just jammed it underneath Gerber. This was some save by Weeks. Pass was taken away by Roosevelt. There's the shot. Weeks took that away, or it would have been 4-1. And puck comes back the other way, put down low here, and it just jammed in front by Pruka. Nylander was there and underneath and in. As a kind of a calm play by Pruka, who misses the puck, but there worked to help get it loose. Puck ricocheted in, and Nylander's quick hands, and we have a 3-2, almost 4-2.
Forced back by Aki Berg. Tootin, pressure from Andras. Here's Pruka, back for the top unit. Nylander to Jagr. Jagr moves in. Still with it. He shoots, blocked in front. Jagr again on the backhand. Save, rebound, score! Michael Nylander! 3-0 Rangers! And Jaromir Jagr has taken over the scoring lead in the NHL. That is his 99th point of the season.
Rangers passes. They must have made 10 passes before they scored. Pruka didn't dump it in. He kept the play alive to Nylander, to Jagr, who will fight to get the puck back here. Right here. Now the puck is finally at the net. Another backhander, and then the goal scored there by Nylander off the goalpost and in. It's being reviewed to make sure it was in, as some of the Leafs thought it might have hit goalpost. Well, it did. It hit the goalpost and went in. It hit the middle bar in the back of the net.
Oh, not in that weather, huh? Here's Jagr, worked on by, guess who? Jan Stastny. Notre Dame University product, Stastny, as Jagr has a couple near him. And the fans are appreciating Jagr's moves. This one deflected up high.
Stastny did a good job. He stayed on the inside of him. Wouldn't let Jagr find a way to get the shot.
Under 14 minutes to go, third period. No change in the score. Rangers by two. Nice move by Pruka. Fed it across. Score! Michael Nylander makes it 4-1.
Well, Jagr put on a clinic at controlling the puck. He was on one side of the ice, went to the other. And somehow, I think Stastny lost the stick. I'm just not sure how he lost it. See, Stastny doesn't have a stick. He goes right at Pruka, goes right around him, and there's the pass to Nylander, and Nylander able to finish. So that's all three forwards getting the job done. The KFC goal cam, I think Thomas got a piece of the shot, but not enough. The momentum of the puck find its way into the net. Somehow, Stastny lost the stick. And when that happened, Pruka went right around Stastny and made the pass across to Nylander.
Further, but that is broken up. Notice that point of game string that Jagr has. 11 games with at least a point. His personal record is 19. Here is a feed by Oslinger-Gress. They score! Oh, what a play across to Michael Nylander. And it's 1-0 in favor of the Rangers.
Well, Mike, the Flyers did not have Gauthier and Desjardins out there. They had Hatcher and Meyer out there. And the Rangers had their big line against Forsberg, and there's Nylander. Look at him drop to the corner. He's wide open, and it's a four-man rush for the Rangers and a little ticky-tack-toe stuff. And there's the Ozilinch pass, and Nylander finishes it. So the Flyers did not have the matchup that they've had in this game against Jagr's line. And
it is Malik again across to Straka. Then the Jaromir Jagr. 116 points on the season for him. Big leader in the Art Ross Trophy race as Jagr breezes behind. Turnaround shot, ricochet off, rebound, score! It is Nylander, and the game is tied.
What's happening here, too, is that the Rangers' big line continues to go like they're going in this game, and there's a game face on that Jagr has. It's keeping the Boston line, their number one scoring line, in their own zone. Nylander will be the recipient of Jagr showing strength with the puck. He is kept to the outside, but look at his strength, trying to get the puck away. In front, Nylander's left alone, rebound goes right to him, and he's able to score in the backhand. Look how many Bruins go over. Bergeron's going there, the defenseman's there, and Nylander's wide open, and he scores on the backhand. The Rangers have tied this game up at two, and by the way, Jagr
is now, as well as Glenn Murray. So still offense is out there among the forwards for the Bruins. Laid onto the back now, controlled by Cody. Spun one, Nylander, score!
Michael Nylander wins it in sudden death overtime for the Rangers, 4-3. They have 100 points for the third time in their history.
Quick hands of Michael Nylander, top corner shot. Jagr did the job with the puck to gain the zone. Nylander with a quick move. He likes to turn, spin, and he feeds Pody. Finally some space. And then in front, the puck ricocheted off of Glenn Murray right to Nylander. And the shot went off the crossbar. May have hit the goaltender on the way down and then back over the line. Nylander took the puck off, escaped to his stick. Rangers win it in overtime, a 4-3. And another point to give them, as you mentioned, Mike, 100 in the race for the Atlantic Division.
Rangers now with 100 points. Philadelphia will play later tonight at home against Toronto in the Atlantic Division with 95.
Here's the shot off the crossbar, down and in. Nylander had the puck not go directly to his stick. It went off of Glenn Murray's stick, who tried to intercept the pass from Pody, and then off the skate and to his hands and in.
Pierre is downstairs with the man who had two goals and an assist today, Michael Nylander.
Michael, two goals in this game. You like playing in Boston, don't you?
It's a great hockey atmosphere. It's fun. The team has been playing well all year. And, you know, we need us 2 points and try to make a run for the top in our division.
When you're a center iceman playing with Jaromir Jagr, what's the most important thing for you to concentrate on?
Jags. Jags is a demanding player. He wants to puck, he wants to create, he wants to score, he wants to, you know, produce for the team, and he's an excellent player. And he has high demands on himself and his teammates, and, you know, he pushes everybody. Good.
You have Henrik Lundqvist here as a fellow Swede. Are you learning any Czech with all the Czechs that are around you?
Stay away from that language. Keep the Swedish and English. And some French, mate. French, too, sometimes. For you. Because of you. You remember you teach me in Hartford? All the French?
That's right.
Well, you give me shit all the time.
Thank you very much, Michael. Back to you, Doc.
I believe that.
Jagr. And Nylander picks it up. Rangers have won 5 in a row over the Islanders coming into tonight's game. That pass in front, and it's stuffed in by Nylander, and the Rangers break through. 3:02 into the third, the Rangers are on the board. It's 3-1. And this was against that checking line, as you're going to see the play here, as York moved in, went to the backhand, had 2 shots in weeks, so he made the appropriate saves here in the third. Jagr on the puck. He just throws it at the net, and it went off the defender, and I think that was Martinik. Martinik wanted to play the puck, lost it right in there. Nylander casually went to the net, and you're going to see the goaltender. Watch the goaltender, DiPietro, move across, take himself out of the play. Nylander was there, and the Rangers are on the
board. Anson, Mark Shuchek are the linesmen. Jagr with a puck, and Gagne on him. Jagr shoots off the glove of Nidamaki. Robert Esch played the season opener for the Flyers Thursday night in Pittsburgh. That shot toward the net, off the glove, a rebound chance, and the Rangers score. It's Michael Nylander, got knocked down hard, and the Rangers grab a 1-0 lead as Nidamaki mishandled the shot.
Yeah, exactly. Nidamaki only played 2 periods of preseason hockey because of being injured. Now look at the play by Jagr. He'll take the shot there. Looked like he got a piece of it, maybe the side of the net. Look at the Rangers just go after the puck. The movement, Jagr, they keep going. They keep looking for the open man. And who finds him? Jagr to Malik, the quick shot, the rebound, and Nylander just fights off everybody in front of the net. And Sam, you and I talked a little earlier, and here's the play again. We talked about the importance. If the Rangers can get an early goal or two, this crowd.
5 seconds to go on the two-man advantage. Jagr. You see this? It's forward on forward. They're forcing them to go down the goal line. There it is. And Pruka parked off the post here. Nylander with a puck. He can dish it. Jagr to Nylander. Back to Jagr. And he risks one wide of the goal. Pruka can't get to it. He'll take it off the end boards. Pruka wants to bring it to the net. Throws it in front. Nylander. He shoots and scores. Well, they had that option open to them for a while. They finally found it.
They finally figured it out. Andre Savard had his forwards up there. They forced the issue. They're going to say that we're going to let Pruka and Nylander beat you in front of the cage. We're not going to let Shanahan and Jagr beat you from up top. So the Rangers found that. It took them a while to find it. Finally, they go down low on the goal line, make that pass from the goal line, and it was brilliant the way they did it, Staggy. But you had to give them something. There's something you got to give the Rangers on the 5-on-3, and the Rangers finally figured it out. They had that time. What a pass by Prouka. Over to Nylander. Nylander has really been shooting the puck this season for the Rangers. Look at the dish pass over two sticks. Over two sticks, a dish pass, elevation, 6 inches off the ice, right onto the tape of Michael Nylander, who's got his second of the season.
And scored. Nylander won the faceoff, got knocked down by McCabe, gets up very slowly, but stays on the ice. Bielak for hooking at 2:55. Jagr, Nylander, Shanahan, Straka, and Roosevelt for the power play. Roosevelt with the puck. Now Shanahan. Pekka and Kilger, McCabe and Coverlé, the penalty killers for Toronto. Nylander, Shanahan, Roosevelt. Jagr one times it. Score! Jaromir Jagr. It's a power play goal. Rangers lead 3-2.
Sam, I think Straka is going to end up getting credit for this. Straka went to the front, and Jagr's shot off the pass was hard and low, and I believe, I might be wrong, but I believe Straka was there to deflect it. Or pardon me, Nylander. Okay. I thought it was Straka, but it was Nylander, I think, that just got a piece of it. From behind, you see Nylander watch his stick in front. Right there. Oh, see, yeah. He just gets a piece of it, and it goes through the legs of Raycroft. Good puck movement again by the Rangers, and that's a second power play goal for the Rangers as they take the lead 3-2.
Chased by Steven Weiss. Straka. Shot by Nylander. He scores! He found an opening on the short side. Michael Nylander celebrates the birth of his daughter with a goal. That shot saved. That's Calder. Stopped by Weeks. Puck still alive. Gagne shoots. That's a save by Weeks.
Hit him in the face mask.
Back the other way. 2-on-1. Straka, Nylander. Nylander scores! What a transition. Weeks with a couple of big saves. One off the mask. And the Rangers score. And Marty Straka's streak is alive at 11 straight. Nylander gets the goal.
Nice setup by Ovechkin, but the shot broken up by Dinas Zubris.
And he said at that time, Mike, he said, if we're good, he said, we might get something.
Nylander's slap almost got through Kolzig.
He said, we might try and do a deal at the deadline. He likes his team.
Straka sets up Nylander and scores! And the Rangers lead 2-0. That was a thing of beauty.
You know, the Rangers have not, especially this line, have not turned back. When they're going forward, they keep going. They're not stopping in the neutral zone and circling. They're going forward, and it leads to this goal. And they just keep going. This is north-south hockey, not east-west. And they go after it. Roosevelt helps off by joining the rush. And then what a pass from Straka to Nylander, who takes the shot. Didn't look the pass, took the shot, and the Rangers have been awfully good here in the first period. Everybody is
back in. Can they change at this point? No, they're not going to. Madden and Pandolfo stay back out there. Sometimes they'll make an early switch. But now ahead comes a Nylander for a shot. Score! Off of Brodeur! A power play goal. It's tied.
Had that chance, and Tim Thomas made a pretty good arm save.
And right here, the Rangers off a faceoff, able to score. They beat Thomas, and the Rangers make it 1-0.
And the Bruins will remain short for another minute 20. As Shanahan lays it back across, and it is sent back up the wing by Straka, charging after it. Nylander. Nylander breaks free. Score!
Backhand shot harmlessly into the corner. And a half to go in the second period. Stall for Armstrong. Back in front. And Roosevelt waiting for the Rangers. Marcel Hossa drops it off for Nylander. Shoots. Score! Prouka, down low, Nylander, stop, rebound, score! Michael Nylander put in his own rebound. Rangers lead, 1-0. Jagr, stuff in, stop by Emery. Rangers poking at it.
and he put it in. Rangers score as they kept poking at the loose puck. It was never stopped by Emery. Rangers lead 2-0. It might be Nylander.
Back to the line, Roosevelt. On the far side, Shanahan. Shanahan sends it to the front, score! Michael Nylander was set up in front. Shanahan got it there, and the Rangers win this game in overtime, their third straight win in this season series.
Goes around Soure. Plays it to Shanahan. Now Roosevelt. Shanahan. Avery is in front. Shanahan shoots. Save. Rebound. Score. Michael Nylander. It's a power play goal. And the Rangers on a 5-on-3.
Well, if it is, he was here early because the circus was in town and he's added a goal. Here's Jagr working on the near boards, tried to cycle it in and does get it back of the net. Here's Bister being hounded there by Devereaux. They exchange the puck and here's Nylander coming right out in front of the goal. Shoots and scores!
A six-game point streak, 3 goals, 5 assists for Nylander, and he hangs onto the puck 2 or 3 different twists and turns, and then right across in front where Raycroft just wasn't big enough to get there.
The one thing I know about Nylander, he has the ugliest stick in the entire National Hockey League. This guy can't shoot the puck with that stick, so he tends to hold on to it. It's absolutely, utterly ugly. But he gets it done with that stick. And you know, the reason that
hand follows, lost the puck. And Witt back on the ice, gathers it back in with 7:18 to go in the period. Shots are 26-12, Rangers. A steal by Jagr from Witt. Jagr curled, centers, Nylander, he scores! And the Rangers tie it 2-2.
In the middle.
Try to tap it over, but it was blocked. Looks to be with the hit there, but here's a 2-on-2. Hossa broke it up and right to Pruka. He turns, shoots off Levin's glove, and then knocked in. Nylander. And once again, the Rangers have a 2-goal lead.
The Thrashers did a nice job coming back. Couldn't come up with the puck. And we showed you that previous sequence. I think Kari's a little amped up, myself. That was when he swiped at for no reason, and it popped out of his glove as a result. They got back. Look, it's just a long range flip shot. Look, he just snaps at it for no reason. And that's just a kid who's got to calm himself and worry about his job. Here's everybody coming back, and they finally give the Rangers credit. They stood with it and put the puck on net, but that's one that should have just been in the glove.
When you say
sort it out.
Yeah, when you say
controls, gets it to Nylander. Malik and Roosevelt on defense. Tonight's New York Rangers high definition broadcast is presented by Panasonic Ideas for Life. Here comes Jagr. Nice pass, Nylander. Score! Seconds into the game, Michael Nylander gives the Rangers a 1-0 lead.
Now the initial shift had Atlanta putting some pressure on in the Rangers zone, but the Rangers were cool and calm, and it started with Nylander. Now the Atlanta Thrashers want to make a line change, so they send out a different line. That gives a little bit more room to Jagr, who then finds Nylander with room on the left side. Look at the line change by Atlanta. Jagr now has some space. He's got some time. He finds Nylander, and something Nylander has done more of lately, he shoots the puck, perfect shot, 1-0 Rangers.
And now, we're seeing Hossa, Marian Hossa, with Kozlov. There's a chance for Marcel Hossa, save, rebound, score! Nylander does it again!
That line has been unstoppable again in this game. It started with Jagr, and it ended up Jagr carrying the puck in over the blue line, and then the Rangers just kept the pressure in. Hossa, the save there, and Lehtinen tried to kick that puck past everybody, and it was Nylander that found it. Look at the play by Jagr. That's where he starts it at the blue line, gets in, and then here comes the forecheck. Jagr gets in quickly. The Rangers cause the turnover, and then Lehtinen tries to kick the puck past everybody, and Nylander is the late man. He's in perfect position. Up far enough where he can control the puck coming at him, and he scores to make it 2-0. The team had was similar to the Rangers in that they really had to play well and play hard going down the stretch to make the playoffs.
In deep, Nylander scores! Michael Nylander, it's a power play goal and a hat trick. Jagr got knocked down. Meanwhile, play continued, and Nylander gets the playoff hat trick.
Jagr took a hard hit from Garnet Exelby after he made the pass to Roosevelt, and then Roosevelt with a perfect pass to the other side, and Nylander wasted no time at all to get the shot. Lehtinen got a piece of it.
First career playoff hat trick for Michael Nylander. They absolutely love it at the Garden.
This has been some kind of scene for the last 3 hours. Jagr makes the play there, and Exelby with the big hit got his arms up, and there was going to be a penalty. Watch the arms. And the elbows up. There was going to be a penalty on that hit. And Jagr with a great pass. And then here's another one. And the shot, Lehtinen gets a piece of it, and it just bounces over and just makes it over the goal line. For the third goal of the night for Michael Nylander, he had a great start to this game, scoring the first two for the Rangers, including the first one 32 seconds in, and then gets this one, his third of the night. Wanted a quick shot off the pass. Lehtinen gets a piece of it. Power play goal makes it 7-0.
And Exelby gets a penalty to boot.
Yeah.
And another power play coming up. So Jagr got back after being knocked down to congratulate his line mate. Al will be checking out the hats, see if there are any that he wants to take home as souvenirs.
There's probably a trivia answer underneath the pillow, one of those.
Nylander wheeled a backhander, and right there was Nylander again.
Oh, stop it.
Here he is again. Score! Nylander, 1-0.
Well, Nylander was the player that gave the pass to Marty Straka, and the puck just rolled up on him. But the Rangers stayed with it. We talked about the Buffalo Sabres winning battles. Straka gets it back to Mara. What a pass! And a nice little backhand move by Nylander.
Well, Jagr takes up a lot of space. Both Ludman and Nylander go to Jagr. But that whole play stays alive because Alex Kotelik has time and space to get the puck out, and he does it. But there's the subtle hand skills of Michael Nylander, and that's the strength of his game. Yeah, he's got great passing vision, but what a great mover of the puck, and what a great finisher because of his subtle hands.